Praise the Lord. Today's devotion is from 2 Samuel chapter 6 verses beginning from 14 through 23. Here I want to give a background of this portion of the scripture. David wanted to bring the Ark of God from the Philistines. It was in Abinadab's house. He wanted to bring it to the city of David. So people were bringing it, but on the way Uzzah touched it, and instantly Uzzah was dead. God's anger fell upon him. So David stopped moving the ark anymore, and he placed that ark in Obed-Edom's house. And it was in Obed-Edom's house for some time, and David came to know that God has blessed Obed-Edom's house because of the ark. David was so afraid to move the ark again after the incident of Uzzah. Now when he came to know that Obed-Edom's house was blessed, David was feeling comfortable, and he decided to bring the ark out again to take it to the city of David. He brought it out from there, and this time it was on the shoulders of the Levites as God wanted, and placed it on its place. Then we read in verse 14 that David danced in front of the Lord. He took off his royal robe and was wearing only the ephod linen. He was now not looking like a king, but looked like a common man. In verse 20, when he came home after celebrating this with dancing along with other people, his wife Michal was not happy. She confronted him. She mocked him for dancing along with other common men, like an ordinary man with no royal robe on. She didn't like to be called as the wife of a common man. She wanted to be the wife of king. She was not pleased with his behavior. She felt like she was humiliated by her husband's action. Actually, David was dancing along with other people. All were enjoying and celebrating for a right reason, in the right way. David was not alone, just putting out a show. In verses 21 and 22, we read David's response to Michal's words. David says he was dancing in an expression of joy in the Lord. His motive was to honor God, and he himself be humbled and abased. He was not alone for his own glory. He was glorifying God with everyone. He was exalting the name of the Lord. His focus was only God. As John the Baptist said in John's Gospel 3, verse 30, he must increase, but I must decrease. That was David's motive. In other words, he must become greater, but I must be less. As we read in the book of Philippians, may this be our prayer. In the book of Philippians chapter 2, we read, let this mind be in us, which was also in Christ Jesus, who being in the form of God, took upon him the form of a servant, found in the fashion as a man, and humbled himself. David's wife Michal was cursed of God because of her this action, and she had no children till her death. We read about this in verse 23. What do we learn, dear my sisters, from these two incidents? May God through the Holy Spirit help us live in all humility before God. May Christ be honored and exalted in and through our life. And let us focus always on our Lord Jesus and only His glory. Also, let us not provoke God to anger. Michal had the critical spirit that stopped her fruitfulness. This can happen to us in our life. Having critical mind used in the wrong way, mocking God's anointed one, not honoring God, which will stop God's fruitfulness. May God help us. May our words and actions be honoring to our God Almighty. May this small devotion be a blessing to each one of us in the coming days. Amen.